So if you really want to try the Dr. Farrah protocol, again, you have to change your diet. You know, that's the most important thing, because some people, they think that they can just take the, they can do the Dr. Farrah protocol without changing your diet. That's actually one of the worst thinking that you can ever think. Okay.
What about rice for cancer patients, Mom?
So again, I have been always telling cancer patients, okay, this is just with Dr. Farrah's protocol, okay? Again, huwag kayong magagalit sa akin, don't be upset with me, because, you know, this is my protocol and I have used it for 15 or 16 years and it has been proven for me, at least for me, I have used it. So the rice is easily converted to sugar. So if you increase the sugar, so the cancer will be feeding on them. Like again, the cancer, they have 96 receptors for sugar. So imagine you have the cancer cells. So kumakain lang yan ng asukal. Okay? So this is based on my clinical experience. Okay? Kung ayaw nyo maniwala, if you do not believe me, I'm not forcing you either.
No,
okay?
Do whatever you like. But understand, when it comes to 16 years of clinical experience in the treatment of 150,000 patients, you're not gonna change your mind.
Mm-hmm. So bati-bati tayo, you know, in the end, we're just humans. And for me, you know, I just want to help. So I'm not forcing anyone to believe in what I have been using for a long, long time.
No
if
rice,
you want,
no bread, no pasta.
Yeah, no rice, no bread, no pasta, no anything white, no processed food.
Well, the reason being is, again, cancer is sugar metabolic, and we are able to see that, for example, through the mechanisms of a PET scan, which is a positron emission tomograph. Mm-hmm. When we want to see exactly where cancer cells are in the body, basically what gets injected into the body is going to be a radioactive isotope bonded to sugar.
Mm-hmm.
And so when that is circulating throughout the bloodstream, the cancer cells get a significant uptake of that. They get very, very active in consuming that. And it releases a radioactive isotope. We're able to see where the cancer cells are within the tomograph unit.
Mm-hmm.
And so, again, it's sugar that is the significant precursor for that mechanism to work.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that cancer cells are highly sugar metabolic. So why would we have a person consume something that is so rapidly converted into sugar or things that are high in sugar? I mean, for example, you know, people want to ensure their good health, but maybe they should consider not consuming ensure.
You're right. Yeah. So be careful with the food that you are taking in. You know, it's always better to have foods that you grow, that you personally grow. So that includes your produce, your animals, you know, because you know what you're feeding them. Okay? Kasi sometimes if it's commercialized, you do not know, you know, what they're feeding all of this.
No,
pigs.
It's highly, highly processed. You have no idea what's going in there.
Mm-hmm. So it's all very important, you know, that you take responsibility over your health. That's the most important thing. Yeah.
Is black rice okay? Is black rice rice? Is black rice rice?
Yes.
When my wife says no rice, what about yellow rice?
No.
How about blue rice?
Red rice. No.
Red rice, brown rice, purple rice.
No.
They're all rice.
Just wait. Okay. So we're going to do the, I know it's very difficult. I know it's very difficult to digest all of it, you know. But eventually for me, what I can just tell you is you try it first. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then if you're not satisfied, then you can always try a different.
Well, the thing is, if someone is advising you something to do, look at their track record.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if they're saying, well, you know, you should do this instead. Well, great. What results have you had doing that?
Mm-hmm.
If they're a doctor, what results have your patients had doing that?
You're right.
Mm-hmm. You know, look at the results.
Baka mamaya hindi naman sila nakakagaling. Ano? That's the
Farrah, puede po di ba rice? Of course.
Cauliflower. You can also use
broccoli.
What else, honey?
Asparagus.
Not the ones that you like. The ones that we make a pasta.
Oh yeah, zucchini.
Zucchini, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's gonna be nice. GMOs, okay. I think I already tackled about GMOs a couple of FBs ago. And again, GMOs, these are genetically modified organisms, okay? So these are foods or not only foods, these are substances that have been altered genetically to suit a certain purpose. Like the first GMO vegetable, they call it a tomato. I think the name is flavor saver. Yeah, flavor saver tomatoes. Mm. Because they wanted the tomatoes to not freeze during winter. So what they did is that they had this genes from a flounder, which is found in the Atlantic Ocean. So they looked at this fish, and how come this fish didn't freeze? Diba? And lamig-lamig. When it's very cold, how come they're not freezing? So they found these proteins that is responsible for them to not freeze. So what they did is that the scientists extracted that gene from this fish and then transferred it to the tomatoes. So it was successful. It was successful. So they didn't freeze. But the side effect was the skin of the tomato, it become pasty-like. So
didn't taste like fish?
No, it was pasty-like. So they lost a lot of money out of that because they weren't able to sell it to the market. Now the problem with a GMO, because these are synthetic, basically synthetic. So our body, so when we eat them, our body cannot, we do not have the enzyme to break them down. So if we do not have the enzyme to break them down, we can have some form of allergic reaction.
Or inflammatory response.
Or inflammatory response, because that's the first time in our system that we would just eat something that we do not know. So that's why they would always have inflammatory problems. And of course, with inflammation, nagkakaroon tayo na some form of problem. In 2004, they said that most chronic illnesses, this was in Times Magazine, they said the most important illnesses out there right now is due to inflammation, diba? Even heart attack, brain stroke, cancer, autoimmune diseases. So they are saying that they are linked to inflammatory substances. So we have to be careful. We have to be careful with the food. Also with the things that we are putting in our skin. Kasi baka mamaya, nagkakaroon na tayo ng allergic reaction. So, pwede tayo magkaroon ng sakit. You're prone to have dermatitis for something like that. Yeah!
Goodbye! So, corn! Ako, corn. Corn is a GMO, ate.
Mm-hmm.
95% of corn worldwide is genetically modified. Okay. How about soya? 99% of soya.
That's a xenoestrogen.
Yeah, GMO.
Soya is a xenoestrogen.
Yeah. When I was studying, they said soya is good, right? Because it has that genistein. You know, it's one of the substances in
Texas.
Soya that can regulate your hormones, you know. And then with the advent of the genetically modified organism, everything changed. You know, they're not as safe anymore. So they're just foods it's just an imperfect world, you know. That's what I can say, imperfect world.